Hey guys, if you missed my tutorial last week, I've started a new series focusing on the reverse double half hitch knot. Today I will show you how to create a repeating diamond pattern using this knot. As always, if you're enjoying my tutorials, a quick like, comment, and subscribe really does help me out. Thanks so much, let's get started. Cut two pieces of 4mm rope in the color Bisque, each piece is 6 feet long. Cut two pieces of 4mm rope in the colors Vintage Peach and Violet Ice, and one piece in the color Slate Gray Blue, each piece is 8 feet long. Fold each piece in half and attach the cords in this order: Bisque, Vintage Peach, Violet Ice, Slate Gray Blue, Violet Ice, Vintage Peach, Bisque. We will tie 15 rows of reverse double half hitch knots following a sequence to create the diamond pattern seen here. Follow along as I show you how to create this pattern. Head to the description for written instructions on how to create this pattern. Row 1. Tie 7 reverse double half hitch knots. Tie the first 4 knots using the left cord as your filler cord and the right cord as your working cord. Tie the last 3 knots using the left cord as your working cord and the right cord as your filler cord. Row 2. Skip the first cord and tie 6 reverse double half hitch knots. For the first 3 knots, use the left cord as your filler cord and the right cord as your working cord, and the last 3 knots, use the left cord as your working cord and the right cord as your filler cord. For the remaining rows, alternate between tying 7 and then 6 reverse double half hitch knots per row. Row 3. Tie the first 3 knots using the left cord as your filler cord and the right cord as your working cord. Tie the last 4 knots using the left cord as your working cord and the right cord as your filler cord. Row 4. Repeat row 2. As a reminder, skip the first cord and tie 6 reverse double half hitch knots. For the first 3 knots, use the left cord as your filler cord and the right cord as your working cord, and the last 3 knots, use the left cord as your working cord and the right cord as your filler cord. Row 5. Repeat row 3. Row 6. Repeat row 2. Row 7. Repeat row 3. Row 8. Repeat row 2. Row 9. For the first 4 knots, use the left chord as your working chord and the right chord as your filler chord, and the last 3 knots, use the left chord as your filler chord and the right chord as your working chord. Row 10. Skip the first chord and tie 6 reverse double half hitch knots. For the first three knots, use the left cord as your working cord and the right cord as your filler cord. For the last three knots, use the left cord as your filler cord and the right cord as your working cord. Row 11, repeat row 9. Row 12. Repeat row 10. Row 13. Repeat row 9. Row 14, repeat row 10. Row 15. Repeat row 9. I tied the fourth and fifth knots in this row the wrong way, so please disregard that and repeat row 9. It won't affect the pattern from the front, but it will make the pattern look different from the back. Here are a few ways you can incorporate this pattern into your work. Use it as a center design in your work, repeat it across your work to create a full piece using this pattern, or cut it off your dowel and create coasters. I'm working on a tutorial to show you exactly how to do this, so stay tuned for that. Thanks so much for watching.